Hello friends, it's me, Krista. I'm so happy to be here with you again. If this is your first time with us, post a picture on our Facebook page and let us know how it worked for you, and we will send you something exciting in the mail. Are you ready to hear the next part of Joseph's story? I am. Let's start the day with a game. I know you will have fun playing this game. It's called Scoop. Yes, Scoop. For this game, you need some yellow pom-poms, a plastic spoon, and some floor tape. Later, we will hear a Bible story about grain. Grain is like corn. For this game, we're going to pretend that the yellow pom-poms are corn. Parents, if you didn't order the supplies kit and don't have yellow pom-poms, you can use cotton ball. Make a large circle on the floor with the tape. Spread the pom-poms all around the outside of the circle. The pom-poms will represent grain. Give each child a spoon and encourage them to scoop the grain into the circle. Continue until all of the grain is inside the circle. Parents, you can pause the video now and let the kids have fun scooping the grain into the circle. Nice work. You scooped all of the grain. I mentioned that grain is a big part of our story today. Are you ready to find out why? Me too. Before that, it is time for our memory verse. Who remembers our memory verse? Great. Let's say it together. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Jeremiah 29:11. One more time. Are you ready? For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Jeremiah 29:11. Before we visit Ollie and our friends, let's stand up and worship God. See you after the story.
He's got a plan. He's got a.
Yes, he do.
He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know.
That's what I know.
That's what I know.
That's what I know.
Let's go. I know that I can trust him. I know that I can trust him,
yeah.
No matter what the season,
yeah.
His plans are for a reason,
yeah.
I know they are good, I know they are blessed. The reason I know is because he said
he's got a plan for me, he's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me, he's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really awesome plan for me.
That's what I know. Oh, that's what I know. That's what I know. Oh, that's what I know.
And when I'm feeling so sad, hey, when I am afraid, God will never leave me. No, 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 His love will never change. I know they are good, I know they are best. The reason I know is because I said
He's got a plan. Awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me.
That's what I know. Oh, that's what I know. That's what I know. Oh, that's what I know.
Move my head and shake my knees.
trees.
It's me, Kai. I'm so glad you're all here today. I was getting ready for the big ice cream sundae party at the clubhouse. These pictures are a step-by-step plan on how to make the most fantastic, most spectacular, most yummiest to the tummiest ice cream sundae ever. Step one, you get a bowl, a spoon, and a napkin, then you're ready to make an ice cream sundae. Step two, add ice cream to the bowl. It can be any kind of ice cream you want. Step three, add the toppings. Ice cream sundaes need lots of toppings. Step four, and what's the last thing we do with our ice cream sundae? We eat it. What a great plan.
Hoo, hoo.
It's Ollie.
Hello, Kai. Hoo, hoo. What are you up to?
Hi, Ollie. Well, I just finished putting together my plan to make the perfect ice cream sundae.
Yes, that is an excellent plan. It's true. I have a story about another great plan for you. Just listen to this story. Just follow me through. Who? Who?
Follow me through. Follow me through. Who? Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Oh, hello, friends. I'm Casey, and I'm helping out at the cupcake food truck. Do you want to see my latest, most delicious creation? Ta-da! These are my sweet dreams cupcakes, because in today's story, we're going to talk about someone who had some pretty amazing dreams. If you're ready, on the count of three, yell, tell me a story. One, two, three, tell me a story! Woo! This is Joseph. He was put in jail, even though he had done nothing wrong. Being in jail was hard for Joseph, but God had a different plan. One day, the king of all of Egypt, the Pharaoh, had some dreams he didn't understand. They were about 7 cows. Cows? What do cows say? Moo! You're right. Dreaming about cows is funny. Wait, ooh, let's count the cows in Pharaoh's dream. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7! Great job! 7 cows. The Pharaoh also dreamed about stalks of grain.
Grain?
We make bread out of grain. Let's pretend to have a snack. Yum. Yum! Pharaoh wanted to know what his dreams meant. And drum roll, please. He asked Joseph to help him. Hooray! Joseph was brought out of jail straight to the Pharaoh. He told Pharaoh that the dreams were from God, that Pharaoh needed to save lots and lots of grain because his people were going to be hungry and need it later. Pharaoh was so happy to know what his dreams meant that he gave Joseph a very special job. He put Joseph in charge of all of Egypt. Years later, the dreams came true. People were hungry and didn't have food, so they traveled from all over to get grain from Joseph. Wow! God's plan was for Joseph to help all these people. God has a plan for us too. And God's plan is the best plan. Did you like the story? If you did, give it two thumbs up. Two thumbs up! Hey, Ollie, tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time.
So there's your story. It's all true. Joseph followed God's plan, and we should too.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Who? Who?
Wow, I loved that story. Joseph followed God's plan and helped so many people. I think I got this story. Did you get it? If you did, say, got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good. I'm excited about following this plan. It's going to be delicious. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye!
Wow, I love that story. Joseph followed God's plan and helped so many people. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you got it, moo like a cow.
Moo!
Great. God's plan for Joseph was to help all these people. What an amazing plan. God has a plan for us too, and God's plan is the best plan. Just like he did for Joseph, God has a plan for you. This leads me to a question I have for you. What can you plan to do this week that will help someone? You can plan something to do as a family. Pause the video and discuss with your family. Anything you are planning to do to help someone is a good plan. Our last activity is a fun craft. It's called medallion. Let's make a necklace to help us remember that God has a plan for me. That's what your medallion says. Maybe it looks something like this. Put your necklaces on and ask your parents to take a picture and post it on our Facebook page. I would love to see it. Friends, in all the things that Joseph went through, he loved God. Joseph knew that God had a plan for him, and he knew that God was always with him. There will be times that are hard for us, but we can know that God loves us. God is with us, and God has a plan for us. I hope you had a fun time today. See you next week when we'll hear the last part of Joseph's story.